boring the fuck out of me. I'm not even gonna lie. Like, there's just this section of the game. I don't fucking like the dark, drab, dirty inner building shit.
It doesn't make any sense.
I'm in a department store looking.
There could have been a better way to convey some of this stuff.
Yeah, well, it's an early made game.
It doesn't matter. It's an early made game to me is a fucking Atari game. That's why they buried all those ET cartridges. That's what you learn from. I mean, there could have been such a better way of conveying a story like this. And the same with the combat system. I understand you don't want them to overuse the block system, because if they could do that, they would just constantly block. And there'd be no penalty for that.
Go left, up. Left and up. Right. There you go. Watch sheep runs.
That's so weird.
There you go.
There you go.
I understand that you have to do, like, a light block and then, you know, all that other shit. But this story crap where you gotta pull out your phone. I mean, he has an earpiece. I mean,
we have to see the doodads.
You don't have to. It's right in front of you. Do I really need to see a fake little 2D imprint of a shoe on my screen of my fucking Nokia phone?
I would if I could. It isn't going to help you figure this shit out.
Exactly.
It's all third department.
And the fact that we have some of these levels that are huge as fuck with nothing in them, and they're all trying to be creepy and stupidly scary, is just, like, over the top stupid.
Like
the game. It's just really bad fucking design. And then this stupid fucking thing.
What, it detects a...
The bird, yeah, I got
that. No, actually,
that.
This one I'm looking for, a decaying body.
Really?
So the second one is vastly improved over the first.
Yo, yeah. Oh, shit.
Hey, if you were playing yourself and not watching it, it'd probably be a lot better, but I guess...
What? No, even, like, just sitting through here, I'm just gonna be angry at some of the design choices that they decided to go with.
Come on, man. It's probably a studio's first new game or some shit.
I guess, but...
No, I don't think I'm...
Still.
Come on, where's the methane?
I want to give him a break. This is bad. And something can't detect methane that far away.
This is detecting others... Hydrogen, sulfide, methane.
Okay, then there should have been methane coming off that dead body you just passed, because it just shit itself.
I'm only need a fire axe.
Really, you need a fire axe for that, too.
Alright, time to find a fire axe.
That's probably why that one area opened, so you can backtrack into it, so there's probably a fire axe over there.
Check the walls, might be one of the little cases in there.
I don't think the guy I shot had one.
No, I'm saying where he busted through.
He busted through somewhere?
Yeah, that the wood that fell over.
Oh yeah, I already passed through there.
No, go through there again though.
And now we're saying there's probably a fire axe back there.
Yeah.
Before I do that, double check. There you go.
This is where you landed.
This is where he busted out.
No. Oh, turn around. Turn the fuck around. Turn around. Wait. Go down that way. And hang a right.
I'm on sprint, dumbass.
Where the hell that wooden area is? Take a right. There.
I came from there.
No, the guy just busted through there. Go up the stairs. Is there like a fire axe or something?
Turn around. Left. There was a case there. Oh, that's shadow. My bad. Oh, that's not a fire axe.
Found your bird. Clearly you didn't come through here.
I didn't go in here though. I'm out. I need to get
the vent rebarb.
Actually, shotgun.
Does better damage for whacking.
Does it actually? Really fast, no, it doesn't. This is better. Fire axe. Let's check the thingy real quick.
And the fact that you can't carry multiple items is kind of annoying.
Is there a 10 to survive a horror or
I guess, but still, even Resident Evil allowed you to carry multiple items.
There we go.
You just have a case.
I
This should technically shock both of us.
It's not that strong.
Maybe. No, you can still feel it.
Yeah.
He says he doesn't feel it.
Oh, you're not shaking.
He's cold-hearted FBI. He can handle anything.
Yeah, except being thrown out a fucking window and being chased down by his own fucking crew of people. Now, does this affect your axe durability?
I don't think so. I don't think the axe has durability. Only a few select weapons.
Oh, so you just double back around.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
Might as well use a helmet over there.
Mm-hmm.
So now that you've got the axe, you can use your fake fucking methane detector, stupid shit. There you go, straightforward. Makes no sense whatsoever.
I don't know if there's a device that I could do this.
What, detect methane?
A specific set of methane. Because I'm pretty sure there's other things produce methane.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you could fart and that thing would go bad then.
Or maybe it's taking all multiple chemicals.
Yeah.
I didn't know.
No. I don't see the purpose of trying to find a dead body either.
Well, I need evidence off of it.
I mean, I think we got enough evidence to put together that that guy stole your fucking gun.
Or in the FBI. Nope.
Because he probably works for the FBI.
I can't remember. I think the FBI is actually out to get him.
Who? The main character?
Yeah. I vaguely remember that because he was a really good FBI agent. I think he made them look bad.
Well, with their detecting, their shit skills, yeah, I mean, they deserve to be looked bad. Besides the fact that they sent an FBI agent out by himself without a partner into the field.
Hit a partner, hit the fat guy.
No, those two were cops. That was another FBI agent. They broke protocol.
Yep.
FBI goes on the field and goes out with an FBI partner.
Sure,
yes. Same with cops. You got your partner. You usually get that one fat guy. No, I work alone. And then, you know, they get together and like, you're not so bad. I can work with a partner. And he's like, my partner died. La, la, la. I shot him in the face. And then he shoots you in the face. He's like, I work alone. And then he sprinkles some crack on you. He's like, yeah, crackhead. That's a little too much work.
What is?
Dragging a dead body through an abandoned building filled with crackheads into a dressing room.
Oh, don't you know this guy's super psycho, so the crackheads don't bother him.
I get that. But what I'm saying is, if you kill that body in a, you know...
Yeah.
A condemned building, ha ha ha, you wouldn't need to go about hiding it. You know?
He's not hiding
I don't think
it.
He's hiding it. He's art. Yeah, he's doing his art shit.
Yes, maybe.
Image received. I don't fucking know, dude. I don't know shit.
Well, I mean, I get he gets a hard-on while doing mannequin things, but... it's not quite right. Looks like you have a male corpse and a female mannequin. Exactly the opposite of normal. Well... oh, because the MO was going after Thomas, women and putting in a male mannequin?
Mm-hmm.
It's a good thing this camera tells you what to take pictures of.
Uh-huh.
Shape and color of the facial mark is consistent with the painted marks on all the male mannequins in previous matchmaker crime scenes. But this is strange. Thomas, get a shot of his right hand, will you?
Damn, you're picky.
Right hand.
The one that's tied up.
Yeah. Come on. Come on.
Oh, God, that hurts my eyes.
Yeah.
Oh no, he's missing a finger, just like that handprint that we found in the paint.
What?
So technically, we shouldn't have been able to find a handprint because it was covered with paint, but you know, whatever. FBI gizmos.
Well, he certainly didn't kill himself and set it up this way.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have found the matchmaker.
Oh, that guy was the matchmaker?
Mm-hmm.
So, now the guy that we're hunting, oh, that psycho that you're connected to is not the matchmaker.
Nope.
No usable DNA traces. Killer must have worn gloves, but there is something.
What is it?
Too early to call. Small
particles. Well, there's nothing. I mean, it's 2006. Google exists. I mean, come on.
Another cop dead.
His eyes already look lifelike.
It's kind of blame for this murder, too.
I'm just gonna put you down as every other murder in the book. I mean, you're only killing crackheads.
Shit! I can't hold them off much longer! Dawson, you still with me?
I can't
wonder if I could say this. They probably would have started shooting at you. They're like, hey, that's the FBI cop on the road. He's in a house full of crackheads. He must be a crackhead too. Kill him.
Possible enough to be true.
So please tell me we have to steal the cop car, and then there's a driving portion of this game.
Oh, God. I sure hope not.
I think I've got the newspaper clippings you found in the room at the metro station.
You can't move him.
Each of the articles talks about a serial killer.
I can move, but it won't. I'll stop walking at this distance.
Seven of the nine were crossed out in each of the clippings by a black felt tip marker.
Like the black felt tip marker had anything to do with this?
The matchmaker and the torturer. Of the names that were crossed out, all those cases have gone cold.
Now wait, you can cross off the matchmaker. Wait, what? Are you implying that there's someone stalking serial killers? So what, he goes around killing killers and then he marks off their name in his little personal diary?
Sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
It does, but it adds up. It almost makes sense. Hold on.
Aren't you the one who knows?
Listen, I have to tell you
that. Pretty sure it's not you. It's the guy you're chasing.
No, because I think you were actually gone psycho. And I think you're the one who's actually killing all the people you couldn't catch because of the cases that you failed.
That's what the other guy's doing for him.
The guy that you're psyching to?
Yep.
Is it his little brother?
I don't know if they're family related. I don't know if there's some form of connection between them. I don't know what else is going on.
Cops are breaking, you know, tear
gas and children. They think you killed everybody. You
kind of did. Oh, yeah. Wow, I found jack shit.
Damn straight you did.
I'm getting better at hitting.
Doesn't matter.
A little early, but a perfect time for next time, everybody.
Papa,
we do some laundry and try to find some overall enthusiasm.
Overall enthusiasm. Overall enthusiasm.
Overall enthusiasm. Yeehaw!
I'm scared.
Want to stop for now?
Probably.
Take a break. Get up. Walk.
Yeah, I need to do something to help. Wake me up.